This is a major environmental issue that you cannot see with the naked eye. When you use special sensors and infrared cameras, the invisible problem becomes visible. You start realizing that the magnitude of a problem is more important than you thought, but once you detect it, you can fix it. This is methane. Growing up in Mexico City in the late 80s and early 90s, air quality was a major health concern and it had a big impact. My parents were really concerned about it to the point that we were not allowed to go outside to play. A lot of times we would spend the entire day just indoors waiting for the next day where air quality would be slightly better. I wanted to become a scientist and use my knowledge to help fix one of the major environmental concerns of our time, which is climate change. When people think about climate change, most often they think about carbon dioxide emissions. But there's other gases that also contribute to warming, and one of them is methane. Methane is a greenhouse gas. On the first 20 years after it's being emitted, it traps more than 80 times more heat than carbon dioxide. When people think about methane, they might associate it with cow burps or the waste sector, for example, landfills. Methane is also the main component of natural gas. So when oil and gas are being produced, there's gonna be intended and unintended places where gas just escapes to the atmosphere. When it's emitted by the oil and gas industry, it's co-emitted with air toxics and air pollutants that significantly affect and impact the climate, but also our health.
My name's Julia Golke. I'm a lead senior scientist at Environmental Defense Fund. Currently, we're looking at how climate change affects health and how we can quantify that. Climate change affects health in numerous ways. Extreme weather events, both heat waves and flooding, are associated with emergency department visits, premature birth, as well as increases in deaths during those events and after those events. Also, we see decreases in air quality. Volatile organic compounds, or methane, interacts with nitrogen dioxide in the atmosphere, along with sunlight, to produce ozone. When we breathe in ozone, it increases the risk of death from both cardiovascular as well as pulmonary diseases. What the United Nations Environment Program Global Methane Assessment tells us is if we are able to reduce methane emissions, we can slow warming by 0.3 degrees Celsius over the next 20 years. We'll also avoid 250,000 of ozone-related deaths, as well as 750,000 asthma-related hospitalizations. It may just look like numbers, but we're huge believers in the power of data and information to drive methane reduction. And that's what Daniel and his team are working on, providing actionable data that can accelerate the mitigation of methane emissions.
Methane set is a satellite with an instrument specifically designed to monitor, quantify, and characterize methane emissions. The instrument has enough high precision to provide a full picture understanding of the problem. So what are total emissions, but also where is the main places where we need to take action? Once you've identified where the emissions are coming from, it's relatively easy to implement solutions. In some cases, it's as simple as turning a valve. In other places, it's plugging leaks or closing a hatch. Solutions are there, and the decision makers can implement them once they know where the problem is taking place. The information will be delivered in a publicly available data platform. We've already been testing the instrument when we mounted on an aircraft. And when the satellite finally launches next year, it will be orbiting the Earth, circling it 15 times a day, and allowing us to map roughly 80% of global oil and gas production. This will allow us to monitor all those different regions with enough frequency to understand emissions and take action on them. I want to see a future where science is driving improvements in life and protecting environment and livelihood of people. Data is critical. We make this invisible problem visible.
With the data that's being produced, and then with the solutions that already exist, we really can take action.
We're gonna have a major impact, not just in terms of climate change, but also in terms of improving health around the world.